Okay, students, after completing the two separate lectures, one is for the preparation of the ethers and second is for the properties of the ethers. And we are continuing the second is in the properties of ethers. Okay, so almost all important points are already covered in the first and second lecture. In the first lecture, it is the preparation of ethers from sulfuric acid and alcohol is important, and Williamson synthesis is important. And second is in properties, reaction with HA under different condition. Okay, it was already discussed through the flow chart so that it should not be confusion. Okay, so I think all of you have made a proper notes of that. Now we are continuing with the next method. Okay, these are some books only it is given. But those three, reaction of preparation of ether from alcohol by using sulfuric acid and preparation from Williamson synthesis reaction with HA, these three are very, very important. And one more advanced information is there, cyclic ether, that we are going to complete in this family. Okay, so there, this type of question, rare chances are there, but we should not take any chance. Okay, 99% it will not come, but that 1% also I don't want that, you should leave it. Okay, so with that intention only I am explaining this. Okay, so that means my intention is that before the examination, if you are to prepare, then try to prepare those three reactions with the utmost care. Okay, now here the next properties, we are there in the next properties, reaction with hot and concentrated. Okay, reaction with hot and concentrated sulfuric acid. So you don't get confused, already we have studied that. There we have studied in the preparation of ethers by using sulfuric acid. Their reactant was alcohol. Now reactant is sulfuric acid, but along with it, what it is going to be? Ether. So ether and alcohol, if they react, what it will form? Okay, so the main condition for ethers to react is it react only with 2 degree and 3 degree. At least one of the alkyl group must be 2 degree or 3 degree. One of the alkyl group must be 2 degree or 3 degree. Then only it is going to form a product. Okay, and here not a single product. It will split the given ether into two parts. Okay, mixture of products you will get. One product will be alcohol, another product will be alkene. Okay, so it is not necessary that both will be 2 degree, both will be 3 degree. Okay, so when there is a chance of 2 degree, 3 degree, 1 degree, 3 degree, 2 degree and 1 degree, like that, all alkene should be made preference if it is a 3 degree. Okay, if 3 degree is not there, 2 degree will be converted into alkene and 1 degree will be converted into alcohol. Suppose these two are available, then what happens? 3 degree will be converted to alkene, 2 degree will be converted to alcohol. That is the criteria for selecting the product, which is to be lower degree will be converted to alcohol, higher degree will be converted to alkene. Okay, so for easy example, I have taken this one. Okay, so this is the ethereal oxygen. This is the ethereal oxygen. Now it is connected to one side 3 degree, another side methyl group. Okay, so with this I wanted to make, as per this, this is to be converted to alkene. So for alkene, this hydrogen will be moving here. Okay, then what happens? CH3 will be converted to CH2. Okay, and this already bond will be breaking. So this will be double bond C, okay, then CH3, then CH3, then CH3. Okay, so that means alkene is formed or not? Simple, one hydrogen is to be accommodated with it, then the other product is going to be CH3OH. Okay, so this part, 3 degree part converted to alkene, 1 degree or methyl part is converted to lower part of the lower side. If both are same, then there is no issue. Any can be alcohol, any can be ether. If both are different only, always higher degree is more tendency to undergo alpha elimination. Okay, elimination will be done in the higher degree. Okay, so higher degree on elimination will give you alkene, whereas lower degree on substitution will convert it into alcohol. Okay, so it is just a migration of the hydrogen from higher degree to lower degree. So lower degree will be converted to alcohol and higher degree will be converted to alkene. Okay, so this is the reaction of hot and concentrated sulfuric acid. As a summarizing, I am summarizing it simply. Hot and concentrated sulfuric acid react with 2 degree and 3 degree ether to give alkyl group with higher degree as a alkene, and alkyl group with lower degree will be converted to alcohol. So it is going to give you a mixture of two product. Okay, what are those two product? Alcohol and alkene. Is this part clear? Okay, now we are into the next property, reaction with PCl5. Next property is reaction with PCl5. Okay, as a memory technique, try to write the reaction like this. Okay, even though PCl5, I think all of you are sure that all bonds are not identical. In PCl5, what happens? 3 chlorine are in triangular plane, and one will be above, two and one will be below. So these two chlorines are very, very reactive because of the large bond energy, large bond length and lower bond energy. So this is this chlorine, this is this chlorine, and I am writing all together as a PCl3. Okay, so when it react, ether react with the PCl5 in this fashion. Okay, so one product will be R-Cl, another product will be RCl, and third product is POCl3. Okay, so like this, if you write, it will be easy for you to write the product. Okay, so two alkyl halides will be produced. One will be with the R, okay, one will be with RCl, another will be with R-Cl. If both are same, then you will get 2 moles of RCl. Okay, if both are different, if it is unsymmetrical, then there will be two different haloalkanes. Otherwise, this common product POCl3. Okay, so PCl5 got initials. Since beginning, it has a tendency. Whenever there is a chance, it will exchange its chlorine with the best oxygen. Okay, it feels comfortable with oxygen. It will try to get one double bond with the oxygen instead of two single bond with the chlorine. So whenever there is a chance, immediately it will break and it will make bond with the oxygen. Okay, so not only here, this trick is going to be useful for you in most of the reaction. Okay, wherever you find PCl5 reaction, this is the thing happens. It will exchange the two chlorine, and in place of that two chlorine, what it will take? It will take up the oxygen. This is a general tendency of the PCl5, and the reason for that general tendency also I told you. What is the reason? The two chlorine which are available in axial position, two chlorines which are available in axial position are very, very unstable due to large bond length and less bond energy. Okay, so two product POCl3, and these two can be same or different. That depends upon the type of ether we get. Okay, if it is a symmetrical ether, we will get to only one type of haloalkane. If it is unsymmetrical ether, you will get two types of haloalkane, and common product is POCl3. Is it understood? Okay, we are in the next segment, reaction with acid chlorides and acid anhydride. Reaction with acid chloride and acid anhydride. Okay, so acid chloride, all of you are aware that RCOCl. Okay, what is that? RCOCl. For clear clarity, I have taken it as a R-COCl. Okay, so this is acid chloride, and we are taking every place I am taking as unsymmetrical, because if you can understand unsymmetrical, then it will be easy for you. Then it will be easy for you to understand about the symmetrical also, because if you can deal with the symmetrical, then unsymmetrical, then it will, you will be able to deal with the symmetrical also. Okay, So on reaction of acid halides with the ethers. Okay. So ether I am taking as unsymmetrical. You can apply it with the symmetrical also. Okay. So here very simple. One will be RCl. Okay. One will be what? RCl. And another leftover part R dash CO and OR dash. Okay. So what are the products we are getting here? We are getting first as a ester, another as a acid haloalkane. Okay. So two product we are getting. If the reaction is between acid chloride and ether, so one part you remove as a R and Cl. Okay. So R and Cl is one product. Leftover is R dash CO OR dash. R dash CO OR dash. What is this? Ester. Okay. So two products are obtained here. One product is ester. Another product is haloalkane. Okay. So here I have taken as a chlorine. It is not necessary. It can be any other haloalkane also. Okay. Now if we use this technique, this is just like a technique to remember. Okay. So next is acid anhydride. What is the general formula? RCOOR dash. Okay. So sometimes it can be written in the examination, it can be written RCO whole twice oxygen. Okay. Like this also they are writing. Simple, this is R, this one. Okay. This C, this one. This oxygen, this one. Okay. And this common oxygen is this side. So likewise RCO, RCO. And common oxygen is this one. Okay. So this is how you have to represent. This is how you have to represent. But I am taking the extreme case if they are asymmetrical. Okay. So simple, there will be like circle RCl, like this circle R dash. Okay. So it is going to attach over here and RCO OR dash. Same way RCO OR dash. That means 2 moles of ester you will get. How many moles of ester? 2 moles of ester. Okay. If everything is same, then 2 moles of ester will be same. If different, different esters will be there. Okay. So simple logic you have to remember. Reaction of acid chloride with ether will give you two different product. What is the different product? One product is ester, another product is RX, that is haloalkane. If the reaction is between the acid anhydride plus ether will give you product as a same ester functional group only you will get, but they may be same or they may be different also. Okay, that depends upon the type of acid anhydride you take and type of ether you take. Suppose here dash and here also triple dash, then what will be the ester formed? Ester formed will be R triple dash C double bond O O R dash. Okay. Same way R C triple bond O R dash. So like this 2 moles will be generated. Like this how many moles will be generated? 2 moles will be generated. Okay. So this simple thing you should remember. This circle technique if you know, then it will be easy for you to identify and remember the product. Okay. Now we are in the next reaction. What is that reaction? Is reaction with air and light. Reaction with the air and light. So in this reaction, I am taking it as a R dash CH2 oxygen and R. Okay. In presence of light, atmospheric oxygen react with one of the alpha carbon hydrogen. Okay. So for easy understanding, CH2, I am extending it as like this. Okay. CH2 is there. I am extending as H. So these two oxygen will be introduced between these. These two oxygens will be introduced between these. Then what it will form? R dash CHO OH. Okay. One oxygen is this one, another oxygen. Like two oxygen just between CH and H. These two oxygens are introduced. Okay. So whenever this double bond, two oxygens are connected with single bond, then it is called as a peroxy. Okay. So these are called as a peroxy ethers. Because of this bond, it is peroxy, and because of this, it is ethers. Okay. So when ethers react with the oxygen in presence of light, this oxygen is from where? Air. in ethers when react with the oxygen of air in presence of light. What are formed? Peroxides are formed. Okay, it will retain its ethereal oxygen. It will retain with its ethereal oxygen. Okay, these are the some properties of ethers. Okay, now we are going to start with the very important segment for the specially for advanced. Okay, specially for AIIMS. So up to here it is required for the board exam, required for the mains exam, and in this also today's topics are only peroxy oxygen here and reaction with PCl5 technique. Already I told you reaction with acid halide, also I told you reaction with esters or sorry, acid anhydride, also I told you reaction with concentrated sulfuric acid, also I told you. Okay, now we are going to start with the new topic, that is cyclic ether. Okay, cyclic ether is a very very important topic. Okay, okay, cyclic ethers. Now we are in the next segment of important topic, cyclic ethers. Okay, so cyclic ethers, there are certain commercially sure shot questions are there and direct questions are there. Okay, so these are the four questions which are commercially important. Okay, so as all of you are aware that IIT exams or AIIMS exams are more focused on the experimentals. Okay, so these are commercially important, that's why they may ask their name. Okay, so IUPAC name everybody know, but commercial importance, because of the commercial names, these are important. Okay, first one is 2-carbon. This is a cyclo, and mini first cyclic ether is at least 3 carbons, it should be there. That means number of carbon atoms must be how many? 2 carbon atoms, and one corner is occupied, one corner of a triangle is occupied by oxygen. Okay, and this is most important, oxirane. Okay, so because of its synthetic use. Synthetic use means when you wanted to in convergence, in board exams. Okay, in board exams it is used in different pattern. How it is? To extend the number of carbon atom by 1 by 2, then oxirane is added. Okay, there what happens, this type of cleavage will takes place here, bond will be cleaved and this carbon atom will be attached on the other side, hydrogen will be attached on the other side. Okay, so to increase the ascent series it is called as. Even in mains also ascent series conversions are there. So when all chapters of organic is completed, then we can start with that conversions. Okay, you will be reacting, given one reactant, you have to convert into product. Otherwise in mains exam, this with oxirane, product A with reaction, product B, product C. So identify A, B, C, otherwise identify C, like that questions will be there. Okay, so there we use a terminology called as ascent series, where number of carbon atoms are increased, that is called as a ascent series. So in any ascent series which requires to increase the carbon atom by 2, then oxirane is also used there. Okay, there are plenty methods, like to increase by 1 carbon, normally CN is added. Okay, so likewise to increase by 2 carbons, oxirane, or it is also called as epoxide. What it is called as? Epoxide is added. Okay, then second one is oxitane. Okay, this is a old entrance question, so you have to be very careful. Okay, oxitane is, it is a cyclobutane with 1 oxygen, 1 corner occupied by oxygen instead of the CH2. Okay, then this is most important, but you will not, you know it, but you don't know that it is the same. Okay, so you have seen many times on the arrow THF. On arrow what you will see it as a THF. THF stands for tetrahydrofuran. What it is? THF stands for tetrahydrofuran. Okay, so this is what the tetrahydrofuran. In some places we require a solvent which is non-aqueous, which is non-aqueous. Okay, so there we use as a THF. THF is a solvent, ether. Okay, ethereal solvent, wherever we cannot use water, dry condition we wanted to maintain, then this solvent is used. Why it is important understood? THF is a solvent used for providing the ethereal condition, this and this. These are direct questions. Dioxane and oxygen. Dioxane is simply CH2CH2 and two corners of hexagon occupied by the oxygen. 1,4 dioxane. What it is called as 1,4 dioxygen. 1,2,3,4. First and fourth are occupied by the oxygen. That's why it is called as a 1,4 dioxane. These are name important. This is important in condition of the ascent series. This is important because of its solvent property. Okay. All of them are important, but the difference of importance is at different places. Okay. It's like it is conversion, it is solvent, it is name, like that. As per the exam pattern, you should be able to prepare yourself. Okay. Okay, already this type of questions came commercially important, but this time we can anticipate, we can expect some advanced question like linking up the naming with this topic. Okay, so for safety side, I am giving you examples of the naming in the cyclic ethers. Okay, so like it is oxyrhene. Just now I told you this is a oxyrhene. Okay, what it is? It is oxyrhene. Okay. On oxyrhene, numbering will be start, always starts from the oxygen only. Okay, numbering will start from the oxygen only. So we can go proceed in this direction, we can proceed in this direction, but substitute is on this side. Substitute is on this side. That's why we will proceed in this direction. We'll proceed in this direction. So 2-methyl oxyrhene. Same way here also. Okay, but commercial name you have to use it. Apart from that, IUPAC naming is combined. That's why this type of question this time chances are there. Okay, so it can be from here to here or from here to here. Okay, so but we prefer this place because numbering should be minimum 2,2-dimethyl. What it will be? 2,2-dimethyl oxyrhene. Okay, 2,2-dimethyl oxyrhene. This is about the some commercially important cyclic ether and their naming as per the IUPAC. Okay, now let us study some few preparation methods. Okay, few preparation methods also along with this. First preparation method from the CH2. Okay, CH2 bond CH2 when treated with CH2 bond CH, partial oxidation. Okay, partial oxidation. We will not give complete oxygen. We will give half mole of oxygen. For controlling that reaction, what we use? Ag2O we will use. Okay, partial oxidation is ensured by Ag2O. The purpose of Ag2O, it ensures the partial oxidation only. Okay, so indirectly we can say one oxygen only. So, and here double bond is there. Let us take sigma bond, this is pi bond. So obviously pi bond, it wanted to convert from weak pi bonded to sigma bond. So it will extend like this. CH2 sigma bond will be intact and this weak pi bond will be converted into two sigma bonds. Okay, so this half oxygen, that is oxygen, will be converted like this. First method of preparation, is it understood? So when alkene, that is ethene, undergoes partial oxidation in presence of silver oxide, cyclic ethers are obtained. Okay, now this is rarely used, but most important for the examination point of view. Okay, examination point of view is epoxidation. It is called as a procedure is called as a epoxidation. Okay, epoxy formation, epoxidation. Okay, epoxidation agents are three agents. Okay, first is peroxyacetic acid. What is first epoxidizing agent? Peroxyacetic acid. First agent used is peroxyacetic acid. It is not something new. Already we know this is CH3COOH is acetic acid. Okay, so if I write one more oxygen, then it will be called as a peroxyacetic acid. Okay, for more clarity, for more information, I will write its structure also like this. CH3C, instead of OH, it will be double OH. Okay, simply this is unstable. This will go and introduce itself between the pi bond. Instead of pi bond, this peroxy oxygen will be introduced and it will come back to the acetic acid. So this peroxy will not be there. Okay, so anyhow, I will give you examples there. This is the peroxy acetic acid. Then next one is peroxy benzoic acid. These are the three reagents used for epoxidation. Okay, so benzoic acid also very simple. Benzoic acid, this is benzene, this is COOH. Okay, so if I write one more oxygen, then it is called as a peroxy benzoic acid. Otherwise, structure, clear structure I will draw so that there should not be any problem. C double bond OOH. COOH structure, one will be C double bond and another side it will be two oxygen and OH. This oxygen will go. Okay, because when they in advanced examination, in AIIMS examination, when they wanted to make the question tougher, they will mark it like 17. That means this oxygen will go and react, not this oxygen. This is isotope 16. Isotope with the mass number how much? 16. This is mass number isotope 17. So which will be going for epoxidation? This 17 isotope. Okay, let it be 16 or 17. This oxygen, both are same only. Okay, so either of this oxygen will participate in epoxidation, peroxy benzoic acid. Okay, and out of these three also, this is very, very, very important. Okay, this is called as a MCPBA. What it is called as? MCPBA. Okay, so MCPBA is metachloro peroxy benzoic acid. Okay, it is not nothing new. This I will erase it or I will write it separately. Okay, so this is benzene. Okay, this is benzoic acid. Okay, if I write one more OH, this is peroxy benzoic acid. Okay, now metachloro, this is M chloro. So this is the structure of M chloro peroxy benzoic acid. Okay, so M chloro peroxy benzoic acid is the answer. Okay, and don't expect in examination this much clear writing on the arrow. They will write it as a short form MCO3H. Okay, what they will write? RCO3H. Okay, you should not feel that why this CO3 came and why this hydrogen is came. Okay, so this CO3H, 3 oxygen means you should understand it is a peroxy carboxylic acid. And what you have to do? You should make the reaction of epoxidation. What you should do? Epoxidation. Okay, epoxidation is simply converting double bond into cyclic form. Converting which bond? Double bond into cyclic form. Like C double bond is there. Okay, so simply plus on arrow it will be written as MCPBA. What will be written? MCPBA. M will be small letter. Okay, simply in place of the double bond it will be single bond. This will be the cyclic. Epoxy will be formed. What will be formed? Epoxy will be formed. Okay, this is the second preparation method of epoxides. Okay, and after that you can extend it by continuing cycle like this. That is not a problem. Okay, okay, now we are entered into the properties of oxirane. Okay, reactions of oxirane. See, this the main problem with this is it is highly strained ring. What is ring? Highly strained. Okay, highly strained ring. What is the strain reason? Bond strain. Okay, see here, each and every carbon is what? Hybridized, sp3 hybridized. What is the bond angle supposed to be? 109 degree 28 minutes. Being a sp3 hybridized, bond angle must be what? 109 degree 28 minutes. But what is the bond angle here? It is only 60 degree. So this is it wanted to get, but this is what it is getting. So because of that, it is highly strained ring. So it will try to ring opening. Okay, whenever there is a chance, it will cause the ring opening. Okay, so this ring is causing the unstability. And to unstability, So acid catalyzed, and in the starting, from the starting, in every lecture I will tell you H positive is a electrophile. Where it will attack? It will attack at the oxygen if present. Okay, so it will go and attack at this place. Okay, and what it will form? Hydronium ion. Okay, oxonium, sorry. Okay, this will be the hydrogen with one positive. When next, what happens? Bond can break like this, or bond can break like this. For this, you should remember it is a SN1 mechanism. Which mechanism it will follow? SN1 mechanism. SN1 means immediately something should flash into your mind. Carbocation formation will be there. Okay, so whichever side carbocation is stable, that time that side will be positive, opposite side will be negative. Okay, suppose if it is R' R" and it is hydrogen R, so this carbocation is stable, so positive charge will go that side and alcohol will be this side, OH will be this side. Okay, so this carbocation will be there. Okay, then what will happen? This negative part is there, A-, so that will go and attach itself at this place. Okay, so what will be the formation? One alcohol and one adjacent to you will be A. So this A can be anything, halogen or anything like this. Okay, so this is the acid catalyzed ring opening. Now it is comfortable product. There is no bond strain here. Whatever the angle it wanted to stay, at that angle it can stay. Okay. Okay, so ring opening only we are talking about, but if we use the acid catalyzed, then it will be SN1 and involves the carbocation formation. But if we use the base catalyst, base cannot go to oxygen because this is also nucleophile, this is also nucleophile. Okay, electron rich and electron rich. Obviously, it will go, it will wanted to go on to this carbon atom. Okay, so that time this bond will be broken like this. This will be negative, and actually it is SN2 transition state. Okay, all will happen at one place only, in one go only. Okay, transition state will be there. There is no carbocation formation. Okay, so this is going to be positive, this is going to be negative. So this carbon with oxygen negative, positive is neutralized by OH negative. So like this, this will be formation. Okay, whatever the positive ion is there, like KOH, oxygen, potassium will be attached here. Whatever the cation will be there, that will be attached at this place. Okay, ring opening can be in how many methods? We can use for the acid, we can use base also. But if we use acid, carbocation formation is there due to SN1 mechanism. If we use base, SN2 mechanism is there, it does not involve any reaction intermediate. It does not involve any reaction intermediate. Okay, if you understand the concept of previous reaction, this is most important. This is cleavage of Grignard reagent with cleavage by Grignard reagent along with the lithium aluminium hydride. Okay, so here what can be that this bond wanted to cleave? Okay, what it wanted to cleave, this bond want to cleave. For easiness, I will take this as an example. Okay, so let us take this bond will be breaking. So what it is going to be negative and this is going to be positive. Okay, so MgX being metal, it will be positive, R will be negative. Okay, so this R negative will go and attach here and Mg will attach on this oxygen. Okay, so first product we are going to get is RCH2 oxygen MgX. Okay, then on reduction this Mg will be eliminated and oxygen will be attached, sorry, hydrogen will be attached, and when it is treated with further, this MgX will be converted into alcohol, RCH2CH2OH. Okay, so this is how we are going to get it. Is it understood? These are some important properties of ethers. Okay, all of you understood? No problem.